Hello, so here we are, the day after Sobrok has been released, and I'm really looking forward to listening to this album. The only stuff I've heard, obviously, are the four songs that have already been released, Last Train Home, Guess I Just Feel Like, Carry Me Away, and there's one other, I can't remember the other one. But yeah, love what I've heard so far. Can't wait to go through this album, pick out some things that he's doing, maybe, on the guitar, see what's going on there. The first track on the album is Last Train Home, which was released most recently, I believe. And if you want to see a full walkthrough on the guitar of this song, by the way, with tab and whatnot, that's on my channel, so go check that out. Here we go, Last Train Home. Yeah. Definitely a lot of similarities between this and Africa in terms of the synth sound and the chords. Yeah, so that pentatonic major scales there. Kind of thing going on. E pentatonic major. Some dulcet tones of Mr. Mayer there. Love that low voice. And if you want to use me, then you got to use me till I'm gone. I'm not a fallen angel. I just fell behind. Lovely bit of wordplay. Oh, yeah. And I really love that bit in that pre-chorus there. And then he goes like that dissonant dominant seventh sound over the chords that he's using. Just, yeah, sounds lovely. And now we switch to like E pentatonic minor, you know? So a little trick on the guitar you can do, let's say you're in E pentatonic minor. Most guitarists will know this kind of shape. Well, if you go three frets lower with the exact same shape, so there's your root note, one, two, three, you get pentatonic major. And it's just knowing where the note E is so that you kind of don't get lost within the scale and you still maintain the right sound. Let's get on with it. Yeah, that's good. I love that lick. Maybe you're the last train. And what I really like in the production on the vocal here is that those low notes really, you've got the proximity effect. I reckon he probably recorded this quite close to the microphone. So you notice if I get closer, my voice gets much, much deeper. And if I get further away, it's more roomy, right? Makes total sense when you think about sound and stuff. When he gets to the line, maybe you're the last train, you know, maybe you're the last train, you can really make out the maybe, the depth of the bass in his voice. Really lovely production touch. I really like that. Oh, I love this solo. Check out this lick, this lick. Such a sick lick, I love that. Something like that. Okay, so track two, Shouldn't Matter But It Does. Here we go. Not heard this before at all. Ooh, hello. Should have done more. Should have learned a lesson from the year before. Just gets you straight away, man. It's like right in the feels, like straight away. Those lyrics are just amazing. What key are we in there? Yes, we've got the E major, then we go to the minor three chord, I believe, and then we go to the minor six chord, and then the four chord. So you've got E, G sharp minor, C sharp minor, A major. So sad. We lost something. I still wanna know what it was. It shouldn't matter. Shouldn't matter, but it does. Now, Now, that's a sign of a great writer. I've never heard this song in my life, right? Working out chords is one thing, but being able to anticipate lyrics is a sign of, like... Well, it's a sign of two things. It's a sign of absolutely rubbish songwriting where they're just repeating the same thing over and over again, which happens more than I like. You know, some of the trash we get on the radio. Anyway, opinions aside, that is a fantastic song because you can anticipate those lyrics, and I've never heard it before. You just know. Obviously, I see the song title, but it's just brilliant. And that's why John Mayer is so fantastic. And it wasn't just the lyrics either, it was the melody. I knew what the melody was because he just knows his melodies, you know? You should have been sad instead of being so fucking mean. Ooh, hello. It shouldn't be easy, but it shouldn't be hard. Now, he doesn't swear very often. I can't think of any other song where he swears. That's actually quite refreshing. So buzzing right now off this song. It shouldn't matter. It shouldn't matter, but it does. Nice. I think we've got 4-1-5 there, so we'd have... Just for the record, I don't know what inversions of the chords or whatever he's using. That'd be too much detail for this video, but yeah, they're the chords. Sounds like he's got open chords, actually. Panned in the left. Shouldn't matter, but it does. Okay. Great. Shouldn't matter, but it... See, again, that's fantastic songwriting because you're anticipating what he did before, but then he goes off in another direction. Again, really good songwriting technique because it's constantly breaking your expectation without taking away from the song at all. It's just adding to it. Ooh. Some lovely clean sounds there, some piano. Woo! That's nice. Nice falsetto there. I have to say, just as that fades out, that's a beautiful, beautiful song. I would definitely be revisiting that later on. So nice. So the next one I have heard, which is New Light. Great song. It's in A minor, if I remember rightly. Yeah. So you remember the chords to this properly. So yeah, you've got... I'm a boy in your other phone, lighting up inside your drawer at home all alone. Yeah, so A minor 7. D or D7. G major. C. G with a B in the bass. For your verse. And you've got that lovely... Dun, 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 dun. So that would be... I think. Yeah, that guitar part. You know, that's one thing John Mayer's always been good at, even if you listen to, like, Your Body is a Wonderland from Room for Squares. He's got all this lovely stuff. I can't remember how it goes now. There's like a lick, I can't remember what key it's in, but it, underneath, and it just, all of this guitar-y stuff happening, and it's just beautiful, and he's doing more of that in this kind of, this recent material. Look at you, what would it matter if your friends knew? Who cares what other people say anyway? Oh, there it is. Very kind of Michael Jackson-esque there. Get the name of the guy who played on Off the Wall, very famous, amazing funk player. Probably shouldn't forget him because I'm a guitarist. There we go. Again, super melody. This solo is really, really short. If you've already heard this song, yeah, lovely, lovely solo. I mean, and his guitar playing so nuanced, you know? I love that chord progression as well. I'm not sure what's happening there, but it's very kind of outside the box. Yeah, that is it's a cracking song, that one. Ooh. Okay, the next one is Why You No Love Me? Why You No Love Me? Sorry, that's me pretending to be Italian. Here we go. People are going to hate me now, aren't they? Oh, hello. That sounded like a Lydian in the opening. Oh. I hope he does that again. Help me. Boo, boo, da, da, da. I think that's it. He probably doesn't do it that way, but that's how it is, I think. Understand it. So yeah, very unusual chord selection for Maya there, actually. Very different. Empty-handed, never heard you say goodbye. Do you remember summer said she'd go forever? Hello. And left me here to cry, and cry. Two chord, five chord. Why you no love me? Four to four minor, classic. Why you no- so yeah, that's that happens in loads of songs. So if we are in E. So. Why you no love me? So you've got D to D minor there, and then. Yeah, I've lost it, but. Bum. Oh, 2-5-1. 2-5-1. Major 6, maybe. So, if we're in A. 2-5-1-B. Why you no love me? Yeah, but that's a classic move as well, going to the 6 major instead of the 6 minor. Yeah, beautiful work, John. This is so original as well, like, Why You No Love Me. Why has no one put that in a song before? I like that lick that was in the background. So it was the thing that was confusing me. It was a 1 chord, but it had a 3 in the bass. So yeah, major 4, minor 4, 1 chord with a 3. So that's D, D minor, A with a C sharp in the bass, and then I think goes to the root afterwards. And then normal 6 chord, and then 2-5-1. And then 1-6. Sorry, major 6. Yeah, so here's an interesting point. Why You No Love Me? That's obviously not American, right? John Mayer's American. So he's playing on the way someone who is not from America, like I mentioned, perhaps it's Italy earlier, and he's turning that into a song. I wonder how long before the Woke Brigade decides that that's not acceptable. The people who are trying to police our language. Anyway, I think it's brilliant. It's awesome. It's expression and it sounds incredible. Let's get on with it. Some slide guitar going on. So we are 4 tracks in to a 10-track album. And so far, I think this has been pretty exceptional from a songwriting point of view, from a production point of view, from a guitar point of view, from an overall musicianship point of view, from a vocal point of view. It's just, it's really, really lovely to listen to. And the album feels like it should sound based on the way it was promoted in the little videos and things he's been posting to Instagram and YouTube and whatever. It's really got that vibe to it. It feels, I want to say 80s, but yeah, I mean, I've already mentioned Toto, so maybe a little bit 80s. Yeah, there's Michael Jackson in there. It feels 80s, 70s, 80s. And his songwriting is definitely in a slightly different direction in certain places, definitely. Here we go. Track 5, Wild Blue. Computer spasm. Something like that, I guess. Without listening to it again, I wouldn't. Never seen the sun before. Oh. Really enjoying the vocal sounds in this. It's kind of roomy. It's a little bit back as opposed to forwards, but it's, yeah, it's lovely. Again. Wild blue, wild blue, be wild blue. Yeah, I think it's D minor, G, C. So 2-5-1 again. Oh, Dire Straits, hello. Oh, hello. And then you've got A pentatonic minor stuff. Ish. It's a wild blue. Yeah, very Martin Knopfler. In the way he's approaching the guitar here. So yeah, you're in sort of A minor pentatonic, position 4 there, pre-bend, and you've got E down to D, and then A, and then hammering from G to A, and then E. Lovely. I like that. Got a nice A minor arpeggio there. These kind of ideas. Yeah, very, very Dire Straits. Hope I'm not ruining it by playing over the song. But yeah, nice. Yeah, very good. Next, Shot in the Dark. Shot through the heart, shot in the dark, and you're to blame. Oh, that's nice. So we're in D. Now he's using slightly different inversions, or the bass line's doing something else to make it sound more descending, but that's essentially D, E minor, D, E minor, D, A. Yeah, dum da dum dum dum. G. A, B minor. So that would be 4-5-6 progression. This feels a bit Bruce Springsteen, this track. Might just because it's got the word dark in. I've loved Seven Other Women. I missed that lyric. Let's just go back just once. I've loved seven other women and they all were you. Oh, flange. I think. So again, really simple solo, but also really nice. So if we're in the key of D, that would be F sharp. I think that's what he did. Some nice slidey bits. I love this piano stuff going on here as well, in the right channel. I'm really a fan of that snare click. Is it called a rim shot? You know, that sort of double time feel. It's lovely. Sounds really, really nice. It's just another shot in the dark. It's just another shot in the dark. Nice chance to relax there, mid-album. More of that funky stuff we heard in New Light. Just B to C sharp. Okay, well, I've heard this next one. Guess I Just Feel Like. B to B sus 4. I guess I just feel like. I guess I just feel like. This is a great song. Really good. Nobody's honest. Nobody's true. So we're starting off in B there. I guess I just feel like. And the other chord, B sus 4. I guess I just feel like. I think it goes down to 6. Nobody's honest. And then probably 4. Nobody's true. Everyone's lying to make it on through. I guess I just feel like I'm the same way too. Yeah, lovely chord progression. It's a 1 flat 7 4. So B, A, E. More of that falsetto. Woo! I guess I just feel like. That's a really nice lyric. Na, na, really nice lick. Na, 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 na. Really nice. I think I remember. 6 chord. 4 chord. 6 chord again. 4 chord again. I guess I just feel like. Back to the 1. And then the bridge. Boom. So we've gone to the flat 7 chord. And then. And then we have the minor 6 chord, and then it goes back and back down again, if I remember rightly. So we got A. G sharp minor. And then F sharp to B. Lyrics to this song are really nice as well. He has this clever way of just making a story fit 3 minutes. Again, fantastic songwriting, always, from John Mayer. Mm-hmm. So for this section, this breakdown section at the end, we've got B, A, and E. Yeah, so kind of Mixolydian, minor pentatonic. Next song, not heard this one. Till the Right One Comes. So that intro bit, oh blimey. So yeah, just having listened to it just the once. Something like that, I think. And he's in E flat as well. This feels a bit like the Eagles to me. Okay. Yeah, so there's a couple of licks in there. That's a minor pentatonic thing. E minor pentatonic. E flat minor pentatonic. Let's carry on. Oh, hello. This is different. This gets everyone clapping. So I think that's... So you're in your E flat minor pentatonic box shape, and you've got the. I really like that blues running. Won't be long. It's quite difficult to do. Won't be long till the right one. Won't be long till the right one comes. Almost. So simple, but so lyrically effective. So we've got some nice funky ideas at the end there. Something like... I'm just kind of guessing it, but again, I'd have to give it a few listens to get to know it properly, but something like that. Next track, Carry Me Away. So I've heard this one before. Lovely production values. I want someone to make some trouble. Again, it's just a testament, you know. I need someone to make some trouble. I've been way too long inside my bubble. And, you know, I don't know. I can't remember whether this was written pre-pandemic or during. But, you know, the word bubble kind of makes you think of that, doesn't it? So it's also relevant. So this is a really nice way he hangs on the four chord. I don't know what key we're in. So, yeah, it's A... Carry me away. You're just going from A to E, 4 to 1. Hanging on that four chord again. Suspense, suspense, suspense. Release. There, 6 chord. 5 chord. What was that after the 5 chord? We got the 6 chord. 6 in. I think it was a 2 chord with a flat 6 in the bass, so that would make it an F sharp with a B flat in the bass. Yeah, it's not a straight flat 6 chord. Okay, so we're at the last track of the album. All I Want Is To Be With You. Very country there. Boom, bam, 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 down, down. Oh, nice, nice vocal sound again. But all I want is to be with you. Mr. Big Vibes here. I'll fade away into the blue, but all I want is to be with you. Interesting that there's a song called Wild Blue. And then we've got the lyric blue here as well. I wonder if I've missed any other blues throughout this album, because obviously the colour of the album is blue, isn't it? So maybe there's a bit of a theme there. Who knows? In fact, I'm wearing a blue shirt. Complete coincidence, but it's meant to be. Getting very Springsteen vibes again. Nice, nice drums. Ooh, Coldplay. Feels like Coldplay. I feel a bit of a breakdown coming on. There we go. Some nice short guitar licks to finish off there. What key are we in? So we're going to have a C major pentatonics. Slide guitar again. Yeah, some nice solo work to carry the album away to the end. Okay. That was a lovely first listen, I gotta say. There's definitely some tracks that I liked the first time a lot. Really liked I Shouldn't Matter But It Does. Why You Know Love Me, really liked that first time as well. I think there are some growers in there, but overall it's a lovely sounding album. It's beautiful. Can't wait to blast it out in the car and add it to the collection of John Mayer albums that I can dip into anytime I want. Yeah, thank you, John. Thank you for watching that video if you've made it all the way to the end. Well done. Very good. Don't forget to check out the Last Train Home cover and the full walkthrough of the guitar lesson with Tab as well. Cool. Thanks for listening. Bye.